I think I'm a very driven person. I don't know where that came from. I always, you know, really enjoyed improving and mastering things and getting better at things and learning things. I love learning, still love learning.
In October 2024, scientist Demis Hassabis was named one of the winners of the year's Nobel Prize for Chemistry. This was for his work on AlphaFold, an AI tool used to predict the structure of proteins. Mr. Hassabis is the CEO of Google DeepMind, Google's flagship AI research lab. He co-founded DeepMind in 2010, and the AI startup was acquired by Google. Mr. Hassabis, who is British, has a Singapore connection. His mother is from Singapore, and his father is Greek Cypriot. He was in Singapore to attend the World Chess Championships in November 2024. I'm Sumiko Tan, and I'm meeting Mr. Hassabis at the Capitol Kempinski Hotel. He tells me how playing chess at a young age shaped him and what he wants to be remembered for. Do you think your chess playing when you were young, you know, did it have an impact on your career?
Yeah, I think it's really good. Actually, I'm a big advocate of children learning chess at school, because kids like mathematics or programming, I think it's really useful to train the mind. Because I started playing chess when I was 4 very seriously, playing for the England junior teams, I think it really was very formative in how I think, and actually introduced me to AI, because I started using chess computers, and I was fascinated by how someone had programmed the physical chess computers to play chess.
You played a lot of chess when you were young. Did you ever wanted to make it like a career?
Yeah, until I was about 12 years old. My plan was to be a professional chess player, you know, grandmaster. And at the time, I was the second highest rated player in the world after Judith Polgar for my age. But then I sort of realized, maybe even though I still love chess and love playing chess, maybe it's too narrow a thing to spend your whole life on. I also discovered computers and programming and AI. I decided that would be my career.
I think Singaporeans would be interested to know, like, your childhood. What were your parents like? Their parenting style?
Parents are, I've sort of described them in the past as quite bohemian. You know, they're very creative. And my dad, he's done many jobs, but he was a singer-songwriter when I was young. He wanted to be like Bob Dylan, I think. Even now in his retirement, he's writing an opera. So that kind of gives you an indication of what he's like. And my mum, she's quite artistic. And then they used to run a toy shop. So I used to get the toys that had missing pieces or games that had missing pieces. And then I used to create new games out of them for my brother and my sister and me to play. So I think that encouraged my creativity. Mm. The main thing about them is they're very encouraging of, if you have a passion, to follow it and to not worry about being conventional, you know, to be quite unconventional. So my career has been obviously very unconventional, and I was very encouraged by my parents when I was young.
Did it push you, though, like to do chess well?
No, not really. It was mostly myself. I think I'm a very driven person. I don't know where that came from. My brother and sister, they're very different. I always, you know, really enjoyed improving and mastering things and getting better at things and learning things. I love learning, still love learning. So for me, chess was great, and the competition and trying to improve your own thinking. What I do now as a career is very fun as well, because I get to learn lots of new subjects to apply AI to.
So DeepMind, yes. And AlphaGo, when you think back of AlphaGo, was it like the start of things?
Yeah, well, we started DeepMind in 2010. So actually before anyone was doing AI, really, we were the first ones to start doing it seriously in the modern era. And then our first big famous breakthrough was AlphaGo in 2016. But AlphaGo was the big watershed moment, I think, not just for DeepMind and my company, but for AI in general. And it was always considered to be a kind of Mount Everest of games AI, to try and build a program that could learn to play Go for itself and then be as good or better than the world champion. So when we had the AlphaGo match in Seoul against Lee Sedol, 18 world titles, when we won 4-1, that was a big moment. That's sort of the beginning of the modern AI era that we see today.
And then from AlphaGo, I mean, more recently was AlphaFold.
Yes, we used games to train our algorithms and to develop our algorithmic ideas.
Right.
So it's very convenient to test out your ideas on games, because you have a very clear objective. You know, you need to win the game or maximize the score. So it's very easy to see if you're making good progress. But of course, the reason to build AI was not to play play games. That was just the means to an end, which was to apply these algorithms to real world problems, really important ones in medicine, in science, and in industry. And then, of course, AlphaFold is a great example of that. So we started that project the day we got back from Seoul and finished the AlphaGo match. So we started in 2016, and then now we've solved all the protein structures.
So what other challenges do you think are ahead of you?
Well, we have many challenges. I have more scientific things that I want to apply AI to. So material design, maybe helping with climate, like modeling the weather, maybe solving a very important conjecture in mathematics. So I think AI is an amazing technology because it can be applied to almost anything. On the kind of more product side, I'm very excited about building a kind of universal digital assistant, an assistant, an AI that can help you in everyday life, do some of the mundane administration tasks for you, and basically help you enrich your life.
What do you want to be remembered for?
I always dreamed about winning a Nobel Prize, and that was my dream from when I was very young, to do some work that would be worthy of that kind of level of recognition, I suppose. As a kid, reading all the great scientists and philosophers and science fiction, and I wanted to advance human knowledge. So I hope, you know, I'll be remembered for doing that and helping the human condition and building technologies that are a great benefit to humanity and solve things like, you know, diseases, which I think AlphaFold will help with, actually.
Thank you very much meeting us.
What I mean that I just keep that mentality of want to beat everybody, and if they get me once, I really, really want to hit them back several times.